set of Tim Burton's Dick Tracy. Bill Maher is here. You know, sometimes when you hear about a Walk of Fame star being unveiled, you think, well, this is just cheap publicity whoring. Bill Maher getting his star is not that. Bill Maher getting his star is long overdue, well-deserved publicity whoring. Bill has earned this star, and the symbol on it will be an old-timey television. But really, it should be a mirror. A mirror on this star, because Bill has always forced society to see and confront its own worst failings. A mirror on this star, for the light that Bill reflects into the darker corners of superstition and fear. A mirror on this star, because you could use it to look up chick skirts, and I think Bill might like that. This is a man who is as close as we get these days to Thomas Jefferson in his vision, his devotion to rational truth, and his love for black chicks. Most of these are just recycled Hasselhoff jokes that I read. The plain and simple truth is courageous, and that's what Bill brings us. He talks to us like we're grown-ups. He pretends we're not idiots, and maybe that's why he's no longer on network television. Bill has what is, in my estimation, the best show on television today. I was a fan before I was a friend, and I remember the first time I did Bill's show. I don't generally find myself in awe, but I could hardly believe I was there on that set. It was like being in the Huxtables' living room on The Cosby Show, or the Cranston's kitchen on The Honeymooners, or the place where all that funny stuff happened on 227. I think Bill could sense my pre-show jitters, because he turned to me and whispered, "It's okay, relax, here, smoke this." And for Christ's sake, do something about that erection. We're live in five. Bill Maher, it could be argued, is our sole remaining advocate for the powers of logic, reason, and critical thinking. In an age where mysticism and superstition are inexplicably reasserting their dark age foreign influence. In an era where more people believe in angels than in evolution, where a progressive president takes a meeting with Rick Warren, and where a crackpot Florida pastor who looks like Jim Broadbent threatens to burn 1,000 copies of Aladdin, now more than ever, we are fortunate to have Bill's shrewd skepticism balancing out our analysis of the world around us. This is a special day for Bill Maher, but really this day should be cherished by anyone anywhere who values independence, truth, and free thought. If there were a God looking down on this ceremony right now, which there isn't, I'm sure he'd smile, give us a thumbs up, and then go back to packing his pawn. Congratulations, Bill. No one deserves this more.